where I focus. This is what I do. So I try to identify the subclinical cases. I try to act when the patient is in the subclinical state. What PSM has taught us? So I am PSM told PARC 10% is a clinical, 90% tip of the iceberg is clinical, 10%, 90% is this. So I thought, why should 90% of people are fighting for this 10%? Let me go deep. I am there. And being an MD medicine, that's always an advantage. Dr. Jaria, sir, it's always an advantage. You enter in, okay, I will do my clinical practice only, but my target is subclinical. And in that also subclinical endocrine. Nobody wants to talk about them. So nobody is talking about subclinical hypothyroidism, nobody is talking about subclinical and hypoandrogenism, subclinical growth hormone deficiencies. I will do it, you guys do it, simple. Then subclinical metabolic cases, obesity, pre-diabetes. You have pre-diabetes, lifestyle change karo, jao. Arre karayega kaun? Suddenly Dr. Jagannath comes up. Do bar khao, 55 minute khao, 55 minute wait karo. Suddenly a keto diet person come. Arre maine sirf akhrot khaye, maine badam khaye, maine ghee piya, mera diabetes gayab ho gaya. Suddenly, why? Because we doctors are not, Dr. Jagannath is a doctor. He is also PSM. He published his study, very good study. But what he did is not exactly being translated in the media. He did his own good study, right? So physicians have to understand it, but who will talk? How many diabetologists are sitting today and telling a patient what you should not eat? Acha, go to a dietitian. And who are dietitians in India? How many dietitians, I'm talking about popular dietitians in India, have really done the medical nutrition course? Any idea? I'm sure. Because whoever has done it are in the medical colleges. They are in the hospital, in the college. And otherwise, they just go out, do a 1 month course, 2 month course. Institutions are there. Okay, who you are, BCom? Come, learn with us. 3 weeks, you will become a dietitian. She goes out, or 90, why I'm saying she? Because 90% are women. So he or she goes out, starts the practice, dietetics. And that dietitian is telling a diabetic patient what to eat, what not to eat. And you see the prescription of them. They are similar, right? They're printed. They are printed. One idli slash one dosa slash one this. Lot of patients eat everything. And why? Doctors are the best dietitians, undoubtedly. That builder said, I am sitting with my dietitian. I felt bad. But in reality, doctors are the best dietitians, right? They can tell, at least for the medical food I'm talking about. But, so who will do it? Diabetologist is not going to do it. People who are sitting with hundreds of patients outside will not do it. We will do it. Then how can we afford doing it? That's the question. Hey, how are you surviving? We charge premium. We charge good amount. We give good time. Here we work like US. You are with me for 1 hour. I'll charge you for 1 hour like a lawyer. As simple as that. So my house should also run, right? Simple. That is your choice. You want to do masses, having 100 people sitting outside in your cabin? Outside your cabin, or you have 10 people sitting and giving you enough. Choice is completely yours. But for anti-aging, you have to choose that 10, not those 100. Those 100 are for all other. They are taking care of them. And because our need is only this 10, where is the problem? When I started all this training program, a lot of people asked me. In India, it is very common to ask, na? Dr. Deepak, kya kar raha hai yaari? What are you doing? You're creating your own competition. I told one very simple. I have a clear mathematics in my mind. The way I speak, and I don't leave anybody in front of me. Sunke ja, pura sunke ja. So I cannot handle more than 8 patients in a day. 8 is my limit. I'll collapse after 8. Believe me. In my clinic, if there's 9th appointment, I sell next day. Or no, ho gaya to agle chutti ho jati kai baar. Man nahi karta fir aane ka. It's not aging. I have made my this 8. If I am going to see 8 patients in a day, how many patients I am going to see in my career of, say, 40 years. 8 patients, 5 new, 3 old, 5 patients a day. I am working 5 and a half days a week. I don't work second half of Saturday. So 6 days maan lete hain. 5 into 6, 30 patients a week, 100 patients a month, new patient, 1200 in 1 year, 1200 into 40, how much? 40,000 in the whole life. And what is the pool in India? 40 million, 80 million. no competition. But more and more people do anti-aging will increase the credibility. If there's only me, no credibility. If there are 20, there is credibility. And that is the purpose of all this. Course program, workshop, talking, telling everything. Please do. Please write in front of you anti-aging so that I get the credibility. If Dr. Jaria writes, anti-aging physician, he is in Hinduja Hospital, right, sir? I indirectly get a credibility. Oh, Hinduja Hospital also does anti-aging. Oh, good, good for me. Me means everybody, anti-aging. Then comes subclinical nutritional deficiencies. We all do this assessment. B12, vitamin D, vitamin E, folate, iron. Find out. Anemia, patient, hemoglobin 10. Why don't you do serum ferritin and iron? Do it. Because by the time hemoglobin is taken, is deranged, the mood changes will have happened. Believe me. To live, hemoglobin is more important than mood, right? So if I have low iron, I will divert all the iron to hemoglobin synthesis. And I will compromise on my other things, including the mood. So even before a patient is having anemia, mood disturbances do happen. And sometimes HB is 11.5, 11.6. Patient is having iron deficiency. So in PSM, it is said that hemoglobin is a predictor of iron deficiency. No. Borderline low hemoglobin with even a slightest of a mood issue. Look for iron, you will find it low. Got it? Don't wait till anemia has happened, 10, tab iron kar rahe ho. No, no, no. And don't give iron just like that. Recommendation is not more than 3 months in a row. Stop after 3 months. And again wait, and again. Same for vitamin E. Not lifelong. Popping vitamin E every day. No, 3 months, stop it. More than 1 year in any way not recommended, vitamin E. Right, sir? Dr. Jaria, sir? 1 year, more than 1 year not recommended. But how many people you know who have been taking vitamin E forever and doctors writing it? No time, prescription, CT all. No. Very interesting field, believe me, it's amazing. Whatever I'm trying to do is, it's like a crux of 10 years of thought process from the same textbook what we all have read. Then comes subclinical toxicities. Now here come the chelation and all these things. I don't do it, but there are people who are doing it and they are doing a good job. But again, when you start claiming it, it becomes a problem. When you start making it again a bypass and this and clean the toxin, clean the block, it becomes an issue. So let them study more and more. A lot of studies have been published for chelation in the US. It has been granted also. Federal funding has been granted for ECP and chelation both. So that is a good sign. So lead, iron, aluminium, arsenic, all these poisonings are very common in India at least. Because we make food in pressure cooker. US mein to ban ho gaya pressure cooker, right? Kyunki log bomb bana rahe the. Bust ho jata tha. So pressure cooker, most of the pressure cooker are aluminium made. You are using every other utensil of steel, but pressure cooker is steel or aluminium, and majority are aluminium. The kadhai, majority of them are iron and others are aluminium, right? In India I'm talking about. Our plumbing work is all lead oxide, so that there is no rusting, but the lead is coming in, right? Groundwater is having, like mainly in Odisha, Calcutta side, lot of arsenic. And groundwater still is the main source of water in India. Even in your part, central India also, arsenic is too much in the water. Clear? So lead ho gaya, arsenic ho gaya, aluminium ho gaya. And then comes, thankfully, the powder, lot of bhasma coming in, energy powders coming in from Ayurveda, from this, coming, containing lot of heavy metal inside. And hopefully, even some homeopathic medication. Because you say that, take 6 pill. But they are so good. Rukta hi nahi aadmi, 6, 8, 10, 12, 15, itna meetha meetha hota hai wo. So that overdosing do happen. So heavy metal toxicity, sometime nothing is coming up. Like sir, in angiography, nothing is coming up in angiography because it is more distal and a microcirculation problem. Angiography is normal. And here the role of ECP is there. Same as heavy metal toxicity, everything is normal. Only hemoglobin is a bit low. Low means not anemia. 11-12. Everything is normal. All hormones are good. Everything is good. All tests are good. CRP is also okay. Homocysteine okay. Problem is heavy metal. and you find it. Then once you found it, either you do yourself or ask somebody who is expert of chelation what can be done. But again, don't go overboard, but should be considered, right? So we should know about everything. Thoda thoda sabke bare mein pata hona chahiye. So we should again do MD medicine. It's practically like that way. Then subclinical lifestyle disorder, which is the biggest lifestyle disorder today, social jet lag. We all are living in social jet lag. We are working in this artificial light. We are working late in the night. Forget jet lag. We are in social jet lag. We are awake when we should sleep, and we are sleeping when we should be awake. So we are going to have those problems of jet lag. We'll talk in when we come to melatonin. Okay, sleep issues. I think every third person today is having a sleep issue. Subclinical mood disorder. Not every mood disorder is depression. India lost the match. I was not feeling good, but I was not depressed. I was low that time. My chacha lost the election. I was not depressed. I was low at that time. Got it? So every feeling low is not depression and does not need antidepressant for long term. That has to be dealt with. But when this lowness happens frequently, then you have to talk about subclinical depression. For everything you are feeling low. And who will identify it? We will identify it. Okay? Anxious, panic, and feeling isolated. People who feel that I am isolated, I am not, you know, I don't belong to this place. They are our patients. Subclinical stress associated disorder, not able to cope up. From students to people working in corporate. Gaon se aaya hai, corporate mein achha job mila hai, not able to cope up initially. Who will support that one? He can't go to a psychiatrist. He is not going to a counselor. He's coming to you. You are taking care of him or her. Interpersonal issues, marriage issues, friendship issues, job issues. So other than psychiatrists, who is handling it? Physicians are not handling it. Diabetologists are not handling it. Cardiologists are not handling it. Either a psychiatrist will handle it or a psychologist will handle it. 90% of psychologists are not doctors, right? They have done psychology, MA or something. Then there is a huge vacuum of people to handle them and make them understand. That also we'll talk later on. That is our job. Then comes musculoskeletal disorder, autoimmune, cardiovascular, skin aesthetics, and that skin aesthetics definitely is the job of the anti-aging setup or whatever. Aesthetics has to be a part of it, because without the outside grooming, as soon as you feel good from inside, you want to look good also. And second is, when you look good, you automatically feel something good inside. It's both ways, appreciation effect. Because as soon as I praise you, you are going to release oxytocin, you are going to release dopamine. Right? Right or wrong? Anybody. You praise me for a bachcha aaya, oh, bada pyara hai. Achhi saadi pehen ke aayi aapki patni. You're looking good. She's happy the whole day. You did not even see that. And you are not going to get dinner that day. Right? That's going to happen. And same way, other way around also. Husband is like all tashan and all. And wife is not even looking at him, and he comes, yaar kya ho raha hai, theek lag raha hu ki nahi, and looking 10 times in the mirror. And anybody says that, abhi main ghusa andar, sir bade acche lag rahe ho, to laga acha theek hai, acha main abhi aata hu zara washroom gaya, theek lag raha hai. This is true. They are logical but applicable. So common issue.